So in this video, we'll look at the Speaker of the Lok Sabha. The presiding officer of the Lok Sabha is known as the Speaker. The Speaker is elected in the very first meeting of the Lok Sabha following the general elections. Now, the general elections of 2019 happened. As soon as the elections were done with, in the first session of the Lok Sabha, in the very first meeting of the Lok Sabha, a new Speaker was elected. So the Speaker is elected for 5 years and is chosen from amongst the members of the Lok Sabha. The Speaker is generally from the ruling party or coalition. However, there is no such rule that says that the Speaker must be from the ruling party or coalition. But because the ruling party or coalition has a majority in the Lok Sabha, so generally the Speaker is from the ruling party or coalition. The members of parliament represent their individual constituencies, while the Speaker represents the full authority of the House itself. The Speaker signifies the dignity and power of the House of which she is presiding. Therefore, the holder of this office has to be one who can represent the ideologies and opinions of the entire House. So we know that from the constituencies, the members of parliament to the Lok Sabha are elected directly by the people. However, the Speaker is representing the ideologies and opinions of the entire House. So the Speaker signifies the dignity and power of the House, and he represents the full authority of the House. He is someone who should understand the ideology of everybody who is present in the Lok Sabha, and he should be able to present the opinion of everybody to the entire House. The Speaker is known as the true guardian of parliamentary democracy. Why is this so? The Speaker, when she speaks for the whole House. It is not for the party. Although the Speaker actually comes from a party, especially the ruling party or the ruling coalition, the Speaker, when she speaks for the whole House and not just for the party that she is elected from. So the Speaker is looked upon as the true guardian of the traditions of parliamentary democracy. The Speaker is higher in rank than all the cabinet ministers, spare the Prime Minister and the Deputy Prime Minister if there is one. So in terms of order of precedence, the Speaker is higher than all the cabinet ministers, spare the Prime Minister and the Deputy Prime Minister. The term of the Speaker begins with the first session in which he or she was elected, and it continues till immediately before the first meeting of the Lok Sabha after the dissolution of the one to which she was selected. That is, till a new Lok Sabha comes in, till that time the term of the Speaker continues, and it is for a maximum of 5 years. The point to be noted here is that even after the dissolution of the Lok Sabha, the Speaker continues to hold office even though he ceases to be a member of that Lok Sabha which is dissolved now. So even when the Lok Sabha is dissolved, the Speaker continues to hold his position till a new Speaker or a Speaker pro tem is elected in the new Lok Sabha. So the Speaker continues to hold the office even after the dissolution of the Lok Sabha till such a time that a new House is convened and a new Speaker pro tem is elected. So the Speaker is also eligible for re-election. The Speaker may resign at any time she chooses by writing to the Deputy Speaker. So how is the Speaker elected? The Speaker and Deputy Speaker are both elected from amongst the members of the Lok Sabha itself. So to be a Speaker, he has to be a member of Lok Sabha. They are elected by a simple majority of the members present and voting in the House. So a simple majority of the Lok Sabha is sufficient to elect a Speaker. There are no special qualifications that are required to hold the office of the Speaker or Deputy Speaker, except that they need to be members of the Lok Sabha. So apart from that, there is no other special qualification that is necessary. However, as the Speaker runs the House and chairs the joint sittings of the Parliament, an understanding of the rules, procedures and conventions of Parliament would be a major asset. Because the Speaker is actually conducting the House, so if he knows the procedures, conventions and customs of Parliament, then it would be a great help. However, there is no such fast and rule that he has to know everything beforehand. One of the first acts of a newly elected house is to elect a speaker from amongst its members. The ruling party or coalition which has the majority can do so easily. However, the speaker speaks for the entire house, and hence a person who is respected across party lines is generally preferred. Hence, over the years, a healthy convention has developed where the ruling party consults the leader of the opposing parties and chooses a candidate well respected by them. This ensures that the other parties respect the decorum of the house when the speaker is conducting it. So generally, a senior member is chosen as a speaker. Such a senior member should also be well respected by the different parties that occupy the seats in the Lok Sabha. This will help in the smooth conduction of the business of the house. Note that there have been instances when a speaker not belonging to the ruling party has also been elected. Another point to note is that the speaker, irrespective of the party that he is elected from, does not resign from his party's membership. For example, the latest Lok Sabha, that is that of 2019, has Om Birla as the speaker. He is from BJP. However, he does not resign the membership of his party. He continues to be a member of the BJP, but he also continues to be a speaker, and he is to represent the interests of everybody that is sitting in the Lok Sabha. In Britain, however, the speaker resigns from his party's membership, and this is considered to be a more healthy practice which the Indian legislature and constituent assembly have chosen to ignore. So what is the procedure for election? So once a decision is made on the choice of the candidate for the office of the speaker, the name is formally proposed by the Prime Minister or the Minister of Parliamentary Affairs. If more than one name is received, then they are entered in the order of receipt. In a newly constituted house, the Speaker pro tem presides over the sitting in which the Speaker is elected. So this is a very important point. We saw that the Speaker of the previous Lok Sabha continues to hold his office even though the Lok Sabha itself is dissolved. He holds it till such a time as the new Lok Sabha sits for the first time. Once a new Lok Sabha comes in, a speaker pro tem presides over the first sitting till the speaker, that is the new speaker, is elected. However, if the elections are taking place in the course of the term of the house, the deputy speaker presides over it. The motions that are moved and seconded by the house are put in order. If any motion is carried through, that is, if there are multiple names, then if one of the motions is carried through, then the presiding officer duly elects that person to be the Speaker of the House. However, if there is only one name that is given for the Speaker, then that motion is moved and seconded by the House, and the House is put in order. So, if this motion carries through with a simple majority, then that person is elected as the Speaker. This is how the speaker is elected. Next, we will look at the removal of the speaker. The speaker may be removed from the house only when the Lok Sabha votes for her removal. A minimum of 14 days notice is to be given to the speaker before the resolution to remove the speaker can be brought onto the floor of the house. So a minimum of 14 days notice is to be given to the speaker before the resolution to remove the speaker can be brought onto the floor of the house. So the speaker can only be removed in the Lok Sabha after giving a notice. So this is about the election of the speaker, his removal as well. Next, we will look at the speaker and his independence. This concludes this video. Thank you.